Thank you. behind it must have gazed with this unchanging view. Trapped inside a prison that was scarcely large enough to contain him, unable to move, denied the release of death. Now his hatred for man must have grown. And that hatred found an ideal vessel in the male of an Andaris. In many ways, Bahamut is to be pitied, not loathed, but knowing the true extent of his fury, I am more convinced than ever of the necessity of our endeavor. Besides, his is not the only soul that cries out for vengeance. At 8,872 realms below the surface, your party arrives within Bahamut's cavernous regeneration chamber as Alizé moves to disable the internment health field. She finds her way barred by her grandsire. The man once gave his life that the realm might be spared if he would honor his legacy, and must now strike him down.
Gods, he is almost whole again.
His size is staggering. I can scarce imagine how Grandfather stood against such a monstrosity.
This cannot be allowed to proceed any further. Let us disable the coil and move on. Dead. I will. will not dishonor my beloved grandsire's memory by calling you such. You are but his twisted shape, the thrall of a mad primal.
You were foolish to disregard my warning, child. Are you so convinced of your own righteousness?
Tis the rightness of our path that led us to return. Eorzea will never be safe whilst Bahamut remains to threaten all we hold dear. What of the hero who gave his life in defense of the realm? Do you truly dispute the justice of our cause?
My poor, ignorant grandchildren, your world is shaped by naught but recent conflict. Listen, and I will speak to you of justice. 'Twas in the twilight of the third astral era. The southern land of Mericidia suffered invasion at the hands of the Alagon Empire. With no atrocity, too depraved for their purpose, the forces of Alec were unstoppable in their advance. Desperate for salvation, the dragons prayed to one of their first brood, to their ancestor Bahamut. Infused by the power of their fervent supplications, Bahamut arose from the abyss of death and took wing as the Mericidians' newborn god. Yet this great miracle would only serve to further the maniacal designs of the dragon's imperial conquerors. The cruel fetters which bind my lord stand testament to the Alagon's boundless greed and hubris. I once summoned the 12 in an attempt to forestall the advent of the 7th Umbral Era. What then did the dragons of Mericidia do that I did not? Wherefore are they accursed and I exalted? 'Tis man's overweening belief in his own primacy that blinds him to the commonness of his condition and the truth of his own tyranny. As long as man is suffered to remain, the dragons shall never be at peace. Only when the plague of people has been expunged shall the children of Lord Bahamut be free. Then shall the world know true justice.
Stop it! Grandfather would never say such things. His belief that people were worth saving never faltered. He had faith in their strength, that they could stand together and push back against the darkness seeking to shape them.
A false hope. 'Tis folly to place one's faith in so flawed a race. Stand together. They would first need to agree on which direction to face. If history teaches us anything, it is that man cannot find common ground between his own two feet. Even you, twins whose veins run with the same blood, struggle to fathom each other's reasoning. You hide your differing agendas behind the convenient banner of Eorzea's salvation. Given your obvious self-interest, can you truly claim no kinship with the Alagon? And though I hope they might bring you closer, 'twould seem that the twin grimoires I bestowed upon you were a wasted gesture.
There may well be truth in your judgment of Alize and me, but such a one-sided tirade, bemoaning the evils of man, rings false, coming from the lips of Archon Nuiswa. Tell me, do you champion the cause of dragons because Bahamut compels you as his thrall? Or is it because you yourself have transcended the limits of man's existence?
Ah, so the possibility did not escape your notice. What I prayed for, what I have become, these are the keys that unlock the truth behind Eorzea's rebirth. If you would have them, then you must needs take them by force. Come, rend this divine form asunder and claim your answer.
We'll be right back.
got from the ashes, damn it.
Grandfather is truly gone this time, but better it end this way than the alternative.
I am yet here, Alize, my dear, sweet granddaughter.
Grandfather?
I must thank you, warrior of light. Without your valor, I might never have broken free of Bahamut's control. These last few moments are mine, to live as the man I once was.
This is all that I wanted. Yet, now that it is happening, I find myself struggling to believe it. Is it really you?
Grandfather, pray forgive me my insolence. It was not my intent to demean you.
Forgive you? I am proud of you, child. You were wise enough to deduce the manner of creature I had become. Alfino, Alize, if any here should beg forgiveness, it is I.
Grandfather, I must ask, will you not tell us what befell during the calamity?
Yes, yes, of course. You have come far to hear the truth. Let us then begin the tale. At the Battle of Cartano, where clashed the forces of the Garlean Empire and the Eorzean Alliance. 'Twas there in the sky above the surging armies that the elder primal Bahamut broke free of the Red Moon Dalamut. In an effort to contain this avatar of destruction, I called upon the Twelve to aid me in the creation of a prison of ether. But Bahamut would not be caged by such feeble bars. Too vast was his might, too fierce his rage. Little choice remained to me. I used the last of my strength to entrust our hope unto the future, and prepared to meet my end. As you have no doubt surmised, I did not perish. When the cage built from the essences of the 12 was destroyed, the sky was filled with a colossal cloud of ether. This drifting energy responded to the prayers of those fighting below, and to my own desperate wish that the dying realm be saved by infusing me with the power of a primal.
Oh.
I became the immortal phoenix, ancient symbol of rebirth. Rising into the sky, I struck Bahamut with all my newfound strength. The blow shattered his earthly form, and a shower of ether rained down upon the land. Thus began the rejuvenation of Eorzea. Believing the deed done, I relinquished my hold on that staggering energy, desirous that it should be returned to the realm without delay. But I had not reckoned on Bahamut's tenacious will. Even as he teetered upon the cusp of oblivion, the dragon reached out to claim me. Alas, within my vast fading form, enough remained of the Phoenix's energy to offer Bahamut a hold, and he dragged me along in his wake.
And thus began your existence as the Elder Primal's thrall.
I cannot help but wonder at his will to survive. Though he was all but obliterated, Bahamut found a way to seize the power you surrendered. That would explain why part of his physical form survived to be entombed underground.
Would also explain why Eorzea was so terribly warped. Even as the land sought to restore itself, the returning flow of ether was cut off.
Ah, very good. When his grip on existence was once again secured, Bahamut did not cease his feast until he had consumed every last mote of ether that yet floated in the air.
And still he was not fully restored.
You must remember that by this time, much of the freed ether had already returned to the land. That which remained was not sufficient to reconstruct so massive a form in its entirety. But there did not need to be. Not for a being sustained by the marvels of Alagon technology. As long as some piece of Bahamut persists, the coils will seek it out and continue their regenerative task. The fragments of Dalamud appear motionless from the surface, but deep beneath the ground they had been searching, tunneling through rock and soil towards their escaped prisoner. And, as you have observed for yourselves, they found his heart. Warrior of Light, heed me. You must put a stop to Bahamut's regeneration. Whether it be for man or for dragonkind, the question of justice is irrelevant. The Elder Primal will leave naught but a smoldering wasteland for both his children and ours. I beg you to defend Eorzea and guide its people to the future they yet struggle to find. This portal will take you to the final internment, Hulk. Tis time for the tale of Bahamut and his part in the calamity to come to an end. Alvino, Alize, pray, come closer. Your hopes and dreams must no longer be an extension of mine. You must needs find your own reason to fight for this realm, your own meaning in this sea of chaos. Will you do that for me?
Of course, Grandfather. I have already made it my mission to see this newborn Eorzea survive and flourish.
Alize, while I was yet enthralled to Bahamut, you spoke of my faith in man's strength. Know that your words reached me, imprisoned though my soul still was. So forceful was your conviction. I wonder if that belief has not become your own. Perhaps, after all your anger and sorrow was spent, you found something greater within you. See this fight to its culmination. 'Tis also your strength in which I have faith.
Thank you for everything. Pray, take your rest, Grandfather. You deserve it.
There are records of an art that allowed one to summon the power of a primal from the essence of its demise. And though I am no true primal, all that I have left, I give to you. Alfino. Alize. My darling grandchildren. May Light's blessings ever keep and protect you.
Warrior of Light, our task remains undone.
Okay, whatever. Whatever. Go away. Doubt not but that the cornered primal will lash out with his unbridled rage. You would overcome this terrible foe. You and yours must be of one purpose. Join now your hearts and minds and sally forth to bring the seventh umbrella era to its true conclusion for the future of Eorzea. Mark the burning heart.
"'Twas a long and arduous road, but at last we reach its end. Farewell, Bahamut. I banish you back to the ether." To grandfather?
You must needs find your own reason to fight for this realm. Your own meaning in this sea of chaos. Will you do that for me?
In fact, I believe I already have. Reason has been with me all along, guiding me. Eorzea's blade of light, shearing through endless shrouds of darkness. I have been shown the miraculous feats of which we are all capable, of which I am capable. Bahamut, you have wreaked enough havoc. I will not let your wrathful fires consume all that we know and love.
To hear you say that. You have found your resolve at last. Let me join my strength to yours. In this place, in this moment, Our purpose has become one!
Thank you.
You did it! But one task remains. With this last coil disabled, there shall be naught left to bind Bahamut to this world. His beloved children will finally know peace. Is done. He is truly gone. You knew, didn't you? You knew what Grandfather had become.
I was not certain, but from all I had gleaned, it seemed a distinct possibility. The scene people describe of the Battle of Cartano is one of unimaginable devastation, and 'tis through the combined prayers of the desperate and an abundant source of ether that primals are born. I merely put two and two together.
And you consider that a sufficient explanation? Well, however you stumbled across your theory, 'twas this revelation that made you wary of my attachment to Grandfather. You feared that in my obsession, I would fall under his primal sway. Is that why you decided to join us? To pull me back should I show signs of wavering?
Pray forgive me, sister. I wished only to protect you. Yet I see now that I needn't have doubted the strength of your conviction. May I ask you a question? What do you now intend to do with the truth you have uncovered?
Which particular truth was that, brother? The fact that desperate prayer gave rise to the primal phoenix? That this new god was responsible for setting Eorzea on the path to rebirth? Should such a tale become common knowledge, people would soon offer up their prayers in earnest. They would beseech Phoenix to complete the healing that was begun.
Yet as you and I know all too well, the very act of calling forth this savior would do more harm to the land than good. We cannot encourage such worship for this very reason. Were Grandfather forced to return as an ether-draining primal, would undo all that he had worked to protect. Your abiding love for him was the key that unlocked the truth of the calamity. But keys may also serve to seal doors that were best left unopened. Let your love now guide your actions, and lock away deep inside the fate of both Grandfather and Bahamut.
Fear not, Alfino. I understand what must be done. The realm need not know the truth for it to be saved. That the Elder Primal is banished, to return no more, that is enough. Let us make our way back to the surface. Poor Orionje must be beside himself with worry.
Presence, I must confess that there were moments when I heard the words, but again, you plucked us from the flames and bore us safe unto victory, just as you always have, Ezra Alize. I have never been more proud to call him my sister. Alize's path. Alize would bring the tale of the seventh Umbral Calamity to a close. And here we are again, after the descent into darkness. The desolation of northern Danelin seems paradisal. As promised, I shan't reveal the truth of the calamity to a single soul. However, the nations of Eorzea will require certain assurances that the threat of a new primal is gone. Kept in the dark over long, 'tis only a matter of time before they seek answers of their own accord. Let us recommend that the fragments of Dalamud are sealed off, that the truth may rest undisturbed. But first, we must go and report to Orianje. It would not do to keep him in suspense. I dare say we shall find him pacing up and down at the Cerulean processing plant. Let's go to the Cerulean processing plant and report to Orianje. It would not do to keep him in suspense. Report to Orianje at the Cerulean processing plant. The Warrior of Light returneth undimmed from the depths of darkness. By the triumph of Baron, I take it thou hast succeeded in thy mission, and yet thou art alone. Mistake me not, dear friend. Full glad am I of thy safe return. But where, pray, are Master Alfino and Mistress Elize? Here, my friend, forgive us our lateness. We took the scenic route. Hama is no more. The realm is safe. Gasp, by the heavens, look at you. What horrors your young eyes must have seen. What suffering your young bodies must have borne. Pray tell me, where are you hurt? Your wounds must needs be cleansed and dressed at once. I shall make for you a poultice which draweth out be at ease, my friend. We are hale and whole, I assure you. We took a few tumbles, but the worst of our hurts are healed. I believe we have Grandfather to thank for that. Master Louisois, then you met with him once more? But wherefore should Bahamut's thrall seek to ease your suffering? I promise to reveal all to you in due course, dear friend. But first, there is a matter which requires our immediate attention. Now that Bahamut is defeated, we deem it best to bar entry to all of the fragments of Dalamud. To this end, we will convince the nation's leaders that the danger is past and invite their cooperation in ensuring that the fragments are never again disturbed. Come, let us depart and seek an audience with them forthwith. A moment, sister. You need not burden yourself with this task. Orange and I will more than suffice. Let you not take this opportunity to rest. The gods know you have earned it. But I am fine, brother. Besides, you have been through as much as I have. Oh, I see now. You would play your game of diplomacy and wish me out of the way. Be further from the truth, Alize. My lady, 'tis mine earnest belief that your brother hath your best interests at heart. You have more than done your part, and he desireth but to relieve you of a burden he might easily bear alone. I have some experience treating with dignitaries, you must allow. And as you never fail to remind me of my fondness for diplomacy, I feel it only right that I remind you of your aversion to it. Then it is settled, Orange. Pray make arrangements for a chocobo carriage. That should give us ample time to prepare our story. Off you know. But our paths are different. We share the same goal, do we not? But of course, dear sister, that which we have just achieved together stands as testament to that fact. Whatever path we choose to take, our hearts shall ever lead us to the same end. Of that I am certain. Thank you. There's a place that I would visit. Might I ask you to accompany me? But first, I do believe a change of garments is in order. It won't take a moment. Landscape is the same. Of course, there is no reason that it would be otherwise. Though it would be poetic for the fragments to magically disappear, I am well aware that they shall remain long after you and I are gone. Typical of you, Ethan, ever the heroine. Even so, I cannot deny that I feel better for your reassurance. But I want you to know that I will never forget. You are the one who freed Grandfather's soul and saved Eorzea from Bahamut's wrath. And though these great deeds will never be remembered in song, the consequences will be felt forevermore by every soul who calls this realm home. if Bahamut was over. The realm, given new life through the prayers and sacrifices of countless souls, will look to a brighter tomorrow. Dust of our adventure in the city, I shall embark on a journey. I mean to find my own reason to fight for Eorzea, and when I do, I will fight with all my being. You have done so much for me, Reaper, and one day I hope to be able to repay you in kind. I have no doubt but that you will continue to help those in need and grow ever stronger in so doing. I shall endeavor to do the same, and if the 12 are kind, I hope one day to become Eorzea's sword in the darkness, as you are. Come what may, you may rest assured that I will not be outdone by Altina. Next we meet, I promise that I will not disappoint you. So that then, fare you well, my friend, and thank you from the bottom of my heart.
yet.
Unbending field duality and borderless duality, no life, no music. If you're playing contents of the borderless duality, orchestral mode. Music well for borderless duality, you still add to your orchestral mode. Unbending field duality, orchestral mode. Music well for unbending field duality, you can add to your orchestral mode. The 24th expert can approach his remaining one minion. No, he won't change your name whenever you like. Do not think this means you can now change your character name. Grace hero in the history of history. Kill Mr. Serendipity replied, Moogles are cutest. Whispered that this triple vagrant is the sole surviving member of a tribe hailing from none other than the moon. We'll see anyway for who he is. A queer fellow with a penchant for giving all he meets absurd nicknames, and jotting them down in his mysterious journal.